excited to be having you on the show, Nadia. So how have you been? How is business? How are things going?
Everything is good. Enjoying this, what I'm doing, because I love it.
And I'm just inquisitive, how did the whole dream start? Because she has a bunch of stores. Like, she has this particular store here in Kabalagala, and then she has one in Wandegea, and she's been dressing up all these big names and everyone else. So how did the dream start?
Okay, it's in me. I've been loving fashion since way back when I was young. You know, like when I could go back home for holidays and my parents gave me pocket money. Seriously, I wouldn't reach school with that money.
You
I could buy
clothes,
yes, buy clothes, shoes, wow. Go sell to my fellow students and what. So after my senior six vacation, I started buying tops, take to, my friends and what. So I just loved fashion. Yes.
It is something that you grew up loving.
And it reached time after conceiving, I gained weight and I was like, getting clothes that fit.
We are going to talk about
yes.
that. Yes.
That's so interesting.
Wow. So what are the biggest problems that plus size women do face when it comes to, dressing up? Because personally, I am plus size. I call myself plus size because I struggle a lot when it comes to, getting the right outfits, getting the right, clothes that fit me. How do you deal with those clients that walk in and they are so insecure? They feel like that's the perfect dress, but manange, my body, it will not fit. How do you deal with this?
So many people come in wearing jeans, what they're like, I love the dresses, but I feel I'm fat, I feel I'm big, I have a big tummy. What I always advise them is to be confident, our weight, it can never go.
It can never go.
Just believe
try.
In yourself,
yes.
And they end up buying dresses, as long as you get something that flatters you. Yes.
So how do you deal with all these different body sizes, body shapes, and then all that? So when they come in, do you cater for all sizes?
Yes,
or you're strictly like size 8,
no,
size
16? I have from size 8 to size 26 UK. So I have all sizes. Someone enters, I'll just get to know, as long I give them freedom, choose what you want. The first dress she chooses, I'll get to know her taste. Some of them, I ask them, how do you feel? What kind of dress would you love? What's the height? I'll just get to know you. And next time she comes back, I'll just tell her, just kindly sit. Let me. Yes, I know what she wants, the height she wants, the material she wants, because we have all types of materials, the heights, if you want short, if you want knee level, if you want long. So I just learned to study my clients. That's it.
But then, do you think colors do matter when it comes to dressing plus size women? I will disagree because I've seen some women do mistakes when it comes to dressing up because of the colors. Like they get the wrong color.
Though
the wrong skin
black, tone. What I know, black flatters.
Yes.
As the plus sizes, but me, I think I don't believe in. Colors that me, as long as you're comfortable, as
you
long as you believe in yourself,
anything,
me, by the way, I don't fear anything. I put on whatever I feel I love. Seriously, I would wear an orange dress, I would wear yellow, I would do anything as long as I feel smart, as long as I feel myself. Yes.
Then Nadia, what's the biggest problem that plus size women do face when it comes to selecting outfits?
Yes.
Because I know their sizes must be there, but then someone walks in and they're like, teri chain toka. And yet you as, the designer, you as the person selling whatever you're selling, you have all these pieces. What are some of those biggest problems that all women that come to the store keep facing?
You know what? Tebe ki di dizamu.
Yes.
Yes. They lack the confidence and they believe, they come in, or in a gamma, me, I want this material. I don't want that stretchy material. Yet, as plus sizes, that stretchy material is the one that will works. Yes, it's the best for us. No, I want that thick material. What? Then after giving her what you think will work for you, seriously, she'll go out smiling.
Yes. And then when it comes to, dressing up for the different occasions altogether, I've seen women do mistakes of they'll wear that dress to the office. It could be like a little black dress to the office. And then they'll say, I'll have my dinner date in this office. Oh, I'm going to go to the club in the same, dress. How do you advise women to dress up for different occasions altogether?
Okay, it depends, with someone. We have all kind of dresses. We have dinner dresses, we have office dresses, we have casual dresses, cocktail dresses, changing gowns, whatever. But remember, there are some dresses that they are multi-purpose.
Yes.
Someone will wear a dress at work. Sometimes she doesn't have time to go back home.
So she wears something.
Yes, the same dress. She just needs to accessorize. Mm-hmm. Yes, and she goes for a dinner. Mm-hmm. I don't think there's a problem with that.
And then what are the best accessories of, you know, changing looks altogether? For example, you talked about someone going, you know, them going to the office in the same dress, and then when they're going out, they will accessorize. Like, how best should women accessorize?
Like with a jewelry. Remember, at work, office, most offices, they don't allow the jewelry, the weaves, those falling weaves. But me, I think, after work, just move with your jewelry at what? After work, do your earrings, necklace, and, you know, put on your heels and go.
Oh,
yes, as you don't have to change. Yes,
very nice. And then when it comes to the bags as well, because I've seen you have beautiful bags.
Thank you.
Women make mistakes a lot when it comes to bags. Help educate us on, you know, what type of bags should women hold when they're going to the office, when they're going out to the nightclub, when they're going out to dinners. Because I've seen ladies that hold these huge bags, like they could be like Chanel, Gucci, or whatever they are, like very big bags. They'll carry them to the office, and then when they're going for the dinner, she will still come with the same big bag. And then when they're going to the nightclub, as if, you know, bagala somba biuma or something like that. Take us through the different types of bags and, you know, when to wear these particular bags.
I think big bags are off.
I know.
Those nice bags, medium, not big, not small. Those elegant bags that someone will, seriously, they are multi-purpose. She will use it at work and after, just like the dressing I've been telling you, the same thing. And most bags come with chains. They come with those small handles. You'll hold it at work, then after work, you just remove that small handle, put like a chain, it becomes like a crossbar. Cool.
Very nice.
Yes.
Interesting. So what are some of the trending, you know, dresses right now? Because you're like the queen of dresses, ladies and gentlemen. Nadia has like the best dresses when it comes to Kampala. But then I've noticed that there's so many trends that do come and go. Because we've had, you know, the maxi ones, we've had the little dresses, we've had the see-throughs. But what are the trends right now? Because I see women wear far and more, they look very expensive. What are some of the trending, you know, dresses at the moment?
You know what I know, the trending dresses at the moment are the free dresses, like the shirts. Yes, the shirts, then with the plus sizes. Those dresses that have, you know, they have that detail on the sides. Yes.
What are some of your fashion style tips when it comes to dressing up plus size women? Because this is like your niche. This is like your area. What are some of?
But don't forget, we have all sizes of dresses, but particularly we deal in plus size ladies.
Yeah.
So, me, what I think and what I see, plus size ladies, like what they need, you don't have to put on, like, you know, there are those dresses, put on your size. And another thing, there are those, you know, most dresses come when they have the details for the plus sizes. It won't show your tummy. And by the way, remember, whenever you're smart, if you're plus size, no one will notice even your tummy. That you have a big tummy, you have tires, no one will notice.
But what's your take on them? Are they healthy? Are they a good thing for women to, you know, wear? What's your take?
I don't think they are healthy. Yes, because they are really, you know, very tight. Like, you become so tight, you can't even sit well, you can't breathe,
but
you can't go
women,
to the room.
Some women have this whole thing of like, I feel like I'm in shape.
You can't even go to the loo. Remember, most of them are full and tight, like down. There's no way you can go to the loo. So, me, what I think, my thinking. I don't think they are healthy.
So you as wouldn't, long as, you
yes,
promote them, you
yes,
stand up
as
for
long
them.
As you wear something that will flatter you.
You know, plus size women do have a problem as well when it comes to shoes. I think because it's not an insult. Mm. Some of them don't know how to balance their body up with their shoes. And then you'll meet this very smart woman dressed up so well, plus size, but then she's struggling in the heels, like she walks like a duck, something like that. What advice, what's the advice you have for, you know, women when it comes to shoes, most especially the plus size women watching right now?
I think we should enforce, like me by the way, with heels, there's that car inch I wear.
I don't go for the 6
Yes,
inch.
I don't, because I know I won't walk, like I won't walk properly, I won't, you know. So me, I think, yeah, there's, you know, nice heels which are like 4 inches. You can do your wedge. Our wedge is also beautiful. I see so many ladies struggling, seriously. They move, you know, like a duck. At even is that, you know, someone is smart from up to down.
I know, but then they're just...
Nah, nah, but like that, you know,
I know, because they want really, to cope up with their trend.
You find someone like, you know, like you're at a wedding and it's you're at the gardens and you know that car thing, someone is a plus size near that car hill. Someone is moving like, oh my God, you're like, what's up? And she's so smart by the from up to down.
Advisable for plus size women to wear, you know, that kind of fabric that is very sheer, that is very, you know, see-through, that is very, you know, like I can see her body shape immediately. I see her in that outfit.
I wouldn't advise that though. Nay, everyone ina chakula chi chayagala
mulembe.
Yes, mulembe. You know, loma ina choice, but me, I wouldn't advise, you know, with us the plus size ladies. Seriously, you have to be, you know, decent enough. You have to. That's why I bring dresses that even my mama wo can come and pick a dress from here. Someone wants a dress for church, you come and pick a dress. But me, I feel, don't seek attention. Yamba something that you feel. But nange every nyama ya fevida vikabo be serious when you know.
I know.
They look really bad. Seriously. But no, I wouldn't advise anyone to do that.
Like, what are some of those, you know, dresses that every woman, when she walks into your store, whether plus size or not, they feel like that's the right number for me?
Everything.
Everything.
Everything in my shop. Everything, because my dresses are unique. They're not those dresses that you buy a dress now, ogende kumukola and you find someone else putting on the same. My dresses are unique. You won't find them anywhere, I promise. That's why I'm still here, and people love my things. Yes.
So who are some of those big celebrities that you've dressed up, some of the big stars? Because I know there's a plus size woman there watching and they must be like, nae sinaba kulaba any big star nga munene nga, you know, probably I am, but did very well from Nadia or something like that. What are
so
some of those
far
big stars?
Not yet. I won't lie, not yet. I haven't gotten that star when like whom I've dressed, but soon coming. Yes, and I welcome everyone. Just come. I'll dress you. If you're small, you're big, just come. I'm here to serve you. But so far I haven't gotten that